So let's see if my camera's actually gonna work and stop bouncing. Stop bouncing. Okay, so I'm gonna do a review of this little supplement. I'm not sure at all how to pronounce that, whether it's Qualia or Qualia or some other thing. Qualia makes sense because that sounds like quality, so that's what I'm gonna go with. So it's called Qualia Focus, and it is a nootropic, which I don't really, it's a healthy food thing. It's a supplement, basically. So there's 100 capsules in this bottle, and at first I didn't really read the instructions, and I thought you just take one capsule at a time, but it actually says you should take 5 in the morning, so I was slow to build up to that because that's like, well, they're huge. They are just powder inside a capsule, so you can actually break them open, but I mean, these things are massive. So, oh, I dropped it. Oops. But see, they're pretty good sized little pills. So the first thing I did when I got these was talk to the doctor to make sure there's no ingredients in here that are going to be detrimental to me specifically, because that's a very important thing to do before trying any supplement. And it's got quite a list of ingredients. It's mostly just vitamins, vitamin C, vitamin D, niacin, B6, B12, pantothenic acid, artichoke stem and leaf extract, Bacopa monnieri leaf extract, alpha glycerol phosphoryl choline, things I don't want to try to pronounce. So yeah, there's like a lot of vitamins and nutrient stuff in there. It's supposed to boost your focus, obviously, based on the name of it, and help with concentration and everything. I've been using these for about 2 weeks now, and again, I kind of slowly built up to that dose, so I was not using the proper dose to begin with, but you know. There's not many left in the bottle because once you get up to that 5 a day, they go fast. It does actually say that the proper dosage is based on weight and not to take more than 7 capsules at once or 9 total in a day. So, you know, if you're lower in weight, I guess you take less. I don't really know what the weight to pill ratio is. It also has a warning about, you know, who shouldn't take it, of course. It has a California residence warning that it causes reproductive harm. So, yeah, I'm not sure what that means, but okay. California is weird about that stuff, so. Anyway, once I talked to the doctor, I looked into some of the ingredients that are not vitamins, and none of them seem to be harmful. None of them are anything I would normally consider taking because, you know, there's not really a lot of peer-reviewed science behind any of this kind of stuff, so there's no real proof. But I went for it, and I can honestly say that about a week into starting taking these pills, I did actually start noticing that I was having an easier time focusing on stuff and concentrating and getting things done that I have been behind on for like months. I'm actually starting to get things caught up again and not procrastinating as much. So it's completely anecdotal, but for me, this stuff actually seems to work. It's a very expensive supplement. Actually, I don't know how that price of it compares to other supplements. I guess it's kind of on the lower end of the range for most of these, I guess, actually. But still, if you're poor or, you know, you're kind of low income, you're probably not going to be able to afford this stuff. The ice fell off the roof. I don't know if my camera picked that up, but anyway, so yeah, the pills don't have a particularly bad smell. I haven't broken any of them open, even though they're massive. I find it much easier to just not try to, like, break them open and mess with the powder inside, because, blah, it might be gross, and I don't want to test that, so, yeah. But they are the kind of capsules that if you have trouble swallowing pills, you could break them open and mix them in with something, I'm sure. It doesn't say not to, or it also doesn't say that you can, so generally, if they don't specifically tell you not to, it's usually okay, at least with medicine, to break it open and mix it in with stuff. So, if, like me, you've reached a point in your life where you're having a hard time sitting down and focusing on everything because you get easily distracted and your brain just kind of wanders off to its own thing, then, you know, You might give these a try. Talk to your doctor first to make sure there's nothing in them that's contraindicated for you. But otherwise, it's working for me, so I suppose I'll keep using them and hopefully get a long-term effect of actually being able to focus on the things I'm supposed to be doing. So, yeah.